Actually, we were the first pop horn band to use a horn section. You know, we were pre-Blood, Sweat, and Tears. Matter of fact, I did a show in Vegas. I went to see a show in Vegas, the new Blood, Sweat, and Tears. A couple of the guys in the band were from the old band. So I watched the show and I walked by the front of the stage to get out because I had real good seats, you know. And a trumpet player was taking stuff down and the guitar player, and the trumpet player says, "I know you from someplace," he said, you know, to me. I said, "Oh yeah?" He goes, "Yeah." He goes, "You're a musician?" I go, "Yeah." He goes, I've seen you someplace. He goes, "What band are you?" I said, "I'm Buckinghams." "Please don't move." He says, "Stay here." So he goes backstage, he gets like six or seven of the guys, they're all young, they're in their 30s and 20s, right? They come out. He says, "This guy's band is responsible for Blood, Sweat, and Tears to go together." I go, "What?" It's a true story. He said, "If you look in the rock and roll encyclopedia, Al Cooper, who was the original guy that put Blood, Sweat, and Tears together, designed Blood, Sweat, and Tears because of the Buckinghams." I didn't know it. It was like, I was going, "Are you kidding me?" He goes, "No, man, it's fact." I went, "Wow."